Well, hi there, folks. This is your host, ID Jester, back in Marvel Heroes. Once again, we're getting these heroes winding down. We're doing all 53 of them. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this is number 50. So I think we have three left. I'm going to have to double check my math, but I think we have three heroes after Doom left. So we are looking at Dr. Doom. And again, he is pretty well set up. You can see we have some really good items for him, some really good everything kind of just ready to go for him. So nice critical damage rating, nice core. Insignia Medusa. Probably need to replace this item if we're trying to squeeze out some more critical hit, brutal strike, or something for him. We could probably replace that item using our Cosmic Nuke Companion. As far as his items go, all Doom items, nothing special. All been upgraded to level 66. So that's good. We are using the Power Cosmic. We haven't quite reached rank 5 yet. Soon, though, very soon, we'll get an even more powerful Dr. Doom. So this is a hero we have spent a lot of resources on. Power dupe, because we actually, when we look at his powers, it's an interesting combination, but we are using the power dupe, and then we are going to get artifacts here. We have the blessed dupe ectoplasm, so you can see that gives us a nice boost in our mental power, and we use one physical power. We have the Blessed Arnett Zolot's ESP box. I think this is the only one I've ever gotten of this. This is the only one I've ever gotten of this. And I think I've only ever gotten two of these items total. So he's got three ultra rare items. So we'll probably just give him a normal item here for his last slot. We don't have a blessing on it quite yet because we haven't decided what we are going to do. And of course, who else to give the Dr. Doom medallion but to Dr. Doom? Again, probably could switch out these for something else. These aren't really giving us any good stats or anything like that. Alright, so strength 15, fighting, I'm sorry, 15, and energy 19, pretty good numbers. Damage reduction is only 35%, pretty low. But damage rating of 3,722 is nice and high. That is really high. Stat-wise, let's look at his stats. Critical hit rating is pretty consistent. Mental is going to be a little bit better. 45, because we are mostly mental, 45.4% of crit. And our brutal strike rating is 45. We'll get that once we get the blessing. We'll get that over 50%. So numbers are really good all the way around there. Really going to be enjoying our playthrough with Dr. Doom. He's got an interesting thing with his powers, though. Very interesting. We should talk about that. So you can see he has three signature powers. But unfortunately, based upon this tree here, you will only be able to activate one of them. So you have the Will of Doom, which is the nice passive power. But it has three choices. You can either choose the tech tree over here. You can choose the middle tree, which is the sorcery tree. Or you can choose Doom's Army, which is the Leviathan tree over here. And so you're kind of restricted. You can't activate any other signature powers other than the one you choose from here. So we're all sorcery all the time. We do have a nice passive over here we put some points into. Gives us some defensive rating and all that good stuff there. And then we have one power over here that we're using, which is the Leviathan Air Defense, which is our only physical attack. It does have a 15-second cooldown, so we need to activate this as much as we can so that we can proc our ectoplasm, our power dupe, and our cosmic power cosmic items. So we need to activate that as much as we can so we can get that physical damage every once in a while. Unfortunately, we can't actually get any energy damage. They're just, you see, restricted. We could use a basic attack as energy. We could do that. That is an option. But I hate to use basic attack just for energy damage, so I'm just not going to use the energy damage. So what are we doing with our mental damage? Well, we're doing Pierce the Veil is our normal attack. You can see it does extra damage against enemies that are affected with Unthinkable and Eldritch Reckoning. So Unthinkable is here. Nice little
Do
area
not
effect
delay
there.
Doom's divine destiny.
And we can have up to three of these areas going at a time, so that's great. Again, with the Pierce the Veil, and we want to get our Eldritch Reckoning, which is down here. Another nice area effect that we're going to layer a lot of damage out on. Of course, our signature power is Mystical Master. So if we look at our bonuses here, we're actually get extra magic, which is our resource down here at the bottom. We store 4% of our magic per second. We actually have a our Mystical Master cooldown was reduced by 10 seconds. So it goes from 40 seconds down to 30 seconds. So that's great. Eldritch Reckoning applies the damage over time. So this now does a nice bit of damage, and then it does damage over time. Makes enemies vulnerable as well. And our Channeling Torment negates 50% of incoming damage while we're channeling and deals an extra 50% damage and gains a 10-second cooldown. So we're going to be activating this for 4 seconds and then letting it do its little cooldown. And of course, we'll be doing our Leviathan Air Defense. The other things are we can actually put a couple points into some of these other effects. Over here is like a really good summon tree if you like to summon. I decided to get away from the summon. There's quite a few characters that can summon people, and I thought, well, I'm just going to try Doom without that. But you can put a point in here into a couple of these categories because if we put one in here, you see the passive effect is we get a deflect rating of 102, but this effect is disabled while this power is in cooldown. Well, we're never going to use this power. We're not because we're not going to summon any shield bots, and then this one here gives us extra range damage 5%. But again, this effect is disabled while your power is on cooldown. Well, we're not going to be summoning in any Leviathan or Infernos, so those are just some extra buffs that we can get. And we actually have a point in over here, which is going to restore 1% of our maximum magic per second. But this effect is disabled again. Well, we're not going to use this, so we're not going to be summoning anything in. But we're going to take the extra buffs, so that's good. Omega System, Warpath, and Sabertooth, and a little bit of Psylocke actually for the mental and physical damage. This is actually we're actually going to crank a few more ranks into that because we had a couple extra points there. We have the Spin Tech for the boss damage. We went down here obviously to get that extra 10 energy and 3 points in the guilt suppression, and that has ranged damage as well as far as our hero synergy goes. Cable, Captain Marvel, Doctor Strange. Doom is actually really good. Let's see if we can get Doom. Who can we get rid of that we don't really? Boy, which one? Energy power. Oh, yes. We can get rid of Star Lord and put it into Doom. So, Doom's claim to fame is 5% extra signature power damage and 5% extra signature power damage. So, he's all about the signature power, which we love. Alright, so Cable, Captain Marvel, Doctor Doom, Doctor Strange, Ghost Rider, Human Torch, Jean Grey, Squirrel Girl, War Machine, and Wolverine are our bonuses, and that's what we get out of it. Just like that. Alright, so let's see how he goes. Let's see how we do. So we have a nice teleportation. It's easy way to get around. Oh, the other thing we forgot to look at. Again, I apologize. Doomsday. So we summon Leviathan Airstrike, which does physical damage. Missiles, which do physical damage. Mystic Lightning, which does mental damage. So again, physical, mental. Hopefully, we get a bunch of procs for all of those items we're working with. So let's go ahead and try out and see how Doctor Doom plays, shall we? All right. So our normal attack. We'll just see if we can show you a little normal attack here. That's our normal attack. So something like that. Then we have our little teleport power, like that. Then we have our unthinkable power. And we can get three of these areas going at the same time. Now we need to proc our... there we go. There it comes. Channel. There we go. And our signature power. Oh, too late. She's already dead. That's too bad. Alright, so I know when we were under attack there, it was hard to really see the powers. But there's our default attack. Here is our... unthinkable power. We can have three of these areas going, which we will spam out three of those as fast as we can. We'll use our Eldritch summoning here. There we go. Just some nice damage and some damage over time. Our signature power, which we will do right now. They exploded into a big pile of goo. Of course, our Leviathan air defense has a little bit of a cooldown, but or a little bit of a time delay there, but you see that does a lot of damage as well. And then last but not least, we have our Channeling Torment, which we can channel for 4 seconds and do some nice damage. All in all, Doom is a really good, easy hero to play. Get off of me, buddy. Get that over there. Get over there. We definitely want to get our area effects. 1.3 million on our Pierce the Veil. That is just insane damage. Insane damage. We're getting our area effect out. Get our area effect up. Use our signature. We killed them all too quick. God damn it. All right. Let's use our drop down power here. 1.7 million there, that's not too bad. Now let's get rid of all the trash. Oh, he stunned us. Nice job there, Batflock. It's a good thing you have all these yahoos running around with you. Let's get our airstrike to come down again. Channel again. Nice damage, nice damage, nice damage. Now our signature power for the win. Bam! And we win. Unfortunately, we didn't get a brutal strike out of it, but I've seen some pretty insane brutal strikes with that and this power as well. Unfortunately, I had to move out of the area because we were under attack there. So let's go after the boss is over here. See if we can get over there before everybody else jumps on him. And activate our ultimate power. There we go. Get a few of them in. That was a lot of damage there again. That's teleports of fools I can't use his crappy attack on us. Got rid of that. Ultimate power. Here we go. Dun, 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 dun. Carry me, my slaves. Come on, turn. Yes, very good.
It was only a matter of time,
Kingpin, before you succumb to Doom's mercy. Oh, that was that huge, huge airstrike again. That's just incredibly good. Very powerful. Which he should be. He is Dr. Doom and all. Let's go after Hyde and see how well we can do with Hyde here. 1 point. Nope, get out of there. Don't get run over. We do not have enough health to really take that. Alright, for the nice damage there. Whoa. Okay. We didn't even need to summon. We didn't even need to bring our... Yes. Oh, we actually got a new item there, so maybe we can... I mean, 500,000 just to send out our little zappy power, or whatever you want to call it there. It's called Pierce the Veil. That's pretty darn good. Let's go ahead and nuke these guys from the. That's a good 500,000 on a bunch of them. Normally it does a lot more damage than that. I'm a little surprised. Alright. Nice. Extra damage there. Yes. We're gonna get both of our area of effects going here. And they will just literally melt in there. We don't even. I could just stand out here and do anything. Oh, hey, you're gonna join us? Alright, good. Yes. Anybody else? Anybody else? No? Okay. Doom just watches you all die a horrible death. We do take a lot of damage. We don't have a great defenses, so the one thing you just have to watch out for with Doom is just to make sure he doesn't get swarmed by a bunch of guys, take a big hit or two, and then you could be knocked out. So just let these guys just stay in our area. Go ahead, hit me. There you go. No, you can't hit me anymore. All right, get a couple areas out here. Get three of them going here. I'll nuke everybody from the sky. God, 1.7 million, and it looks like a 2.7 million and another one over there.
You stop me?
Yeah. He does have some really good items, I should say, as we've been talking about. So just keep that in mind. Not all the... You know, I suppose if I put these on a lot of the other heroes, they would have really good damage as well. But we're talking some super rare... items that you know we're only gonna have to give one hero in the game. So Doom happens to be a really good hero. So yes, I see you there. I see you standing there. Three of these area effects are just so good, so good. And the ability to channel.
Do as Doom requests.
Oh, are they outside of range? No, they're not. Teleport down here so we get the rest of these damn cows and get rid of them. Where are we at? We have just a few more left. And they're still dying in our areas, so... So that is really powerful. Like I said, of course, a lot of the heroes would be ultra powerful if we could get all these items on the hero, so... But I just think, you know, being Dr. Doom and all, he's going to have pretty good stats. He's going to have pretty good powers. So if I'm going to give him to somebody, I might as well give him to a hero I know is going to probably be decked out pretty good in the game, right? And there's a few more cows. Let's get rid of these last few here. And there you go. There's... So I've seen Dr. Dooms running around with like 10 summon characters, and they seem to be a very popular build, but as I mentioned, I'm not going to go that way with Dr. Doom, so I'm going to try just a normal ranged sorcery build here. And our Pierce the Veil actually pierced through enemies, as you can see there. If there was guys standing behind one another, you could actually see that. Let's see if we can line these guys up. Nope. But we don't really need that. All we need is a couple area effects to go off and... Two guys just instantly killed there. Two guys instantly killed there. Three guys instantly killed there.
All will crumble at the hands of Doom.
Teleportation, you know, just a slight plus in my mind. The ability to have it. We talked about the haves and the have-nots in the game. Doom is definitely a have. He is not a have-not. He's got the power. He can bring the heat. He can do the damage. And I'm not even probably doing the most popular build. Obviously, we talked about the most popular build being the fact that people like to summon a lot of characters in with Doom. Okay, I'm getting a little bit of a lag spike here. Let's see what's going on. Just wanted to see if we could sync up the game a little bit before we... There we go. Do that, do that, do that. Do this here. Kill these guys. I'm seeing very choppy. I don't know how the video will turn out, but we'll see. Might be because I'm just too powerful. The game, it doesn't know what to do. It's like, well, wait a minute here. This guy is way too powerful. It doesn't look like I see any other heroes in the game. Maybe one other hero I saw. Just use that. I'm not even going to use my... I'm not even going to use my big boy powers. I'll save that up. For our main attack here against... five bosses. Where are they? Oh, they're way down. Come on, don't you lag out on me when I'm recording a video. That would be very sad. I think we only got a couple heroes left, so that'll be... Alright, so we'll put an area down there, we'll put an area down there, put an area over here, right there. Alright, now we'll nuke everybody from afar, and then we'll ultimate power, or signature power. One guy's down already. Another guy's down already. And I do not believe we have any other heroes here joining in the fight. Okay, you guys are pissing me off. You're actually doing a lot of damage to me, so that's crazy.
For your crimes, you have received just retribution. So speaks doom.
Oh!
Doom is the swiftest way to avoid.
That was cool. If I could take a screenshot, that would be awesome screenshot, I have a feeling. I was actually channeling the air defense and then channeled the torment, and when the air defense hit, it landed right between our channeling torment.
This
that was awesome.
Mine.
That was pretty cool. I have to admit, that was pretty awesome.
Admit defeat.
So obviously Doom is a pretty popular hero to play out there. You see quite a few Dooms running around. Most of them you see actually with characters out there. But I think I'm going to just use the buffs instead of I'll use the buffs all the time. The people that use the channeling don't get to do that. So, and as you can see, he does a ton of damage here. Let's go ahead and nuke him again. And channel. Oh, I didn't time it very well. We'll have to try that again sometime.
What are you doing? My leg.
That is insanely good. Just so powerful. So powerful. And that is, of course, without that final blessing. We should actually look and see what items we got for this guy. Actually, you know what? Before we do that, let's go ahead and grab a couple of these guys so we get credit for the event. In case there's other heroes in here that might finish it. I don't think there is. There might be one other hero, I think, in the game. He is... I'm very surprised, though, at just how much... Alright, here we go. Signature power. Bam! 3.2 million to a bunch of guys. I'm pleasantly surprised how easy he is to play without summons. I was a little afraid he would be underpowered if he didn't use the summons. But fortunately, that is not the case. We still have a few things we can do to him. We do have relics on everything, but let's see here. To do two ranks all powers, one rank to channeling torment, three ranks, and four ranks. We would actually get some more ranks if we upgrade this. Now the question is, let's take
a
look
I
at that.
Have been spending a lot of time in the lab. Why do you ask?
Gear, what slot is that? Slot number four. Let's do an upgrade real quickly here and see if this is going to be a worthy upgrade. So we'd get, 500 extra health. Lose some movement speed, which is not that bad. We'd only lose 2 points in critical hit rating. That's fine. We'd actually gain some brutal strike rating. We lose a little bit of power and magic. That's not that big a deal. 11% chance when hitting with a ranged power to tap into unlimited power, gaining +1 to all attributes for 5 seconds. 11% chance versus 14% chance. That's not that big a deal. And lose 20 points to physical defense. But we would gain 2 ranks to Crumble Fools and 3 ranks to Beneath Doom's Boot. And I don't recall those, so I'm thinking those are probably Crumble Fool and Beneath Doom's Boot. Where is that one? Over here. So both of those powers are over here. 2 ranks and 2 ranks to Channeling Torments. So we would actually... Channeling Torment is right here. So we'd actually lose a rank in that. That's sad. That makes me sad. I would have liked a better roll on the Channeling Torment than the Crumble of Fool or Beneath Doom's Boot. Oh, they did finish it. There are a couple heroes. So we would actually end up losing 1 rank, which is not that bad, but we get some extra health. Is it worth it? I don't know. I'm going to set it there. We'll look at it in between episodes. I'll gander it over and agonize on whether or not it's something to upgrade or not. Anything else? We don't need that. Go away. Oh, yes, that's what we're going to do. We're going to look to see what other item we could give to Doom here. We have a nice Blessed Advanced Metasensory Array, which already got Blessing on it. We got this off of X23. He doesn't have one. It would give him +1 to all of our powers. Yep, I think we're going to give it to Doom. Doom is worth it. He is definitely in my eyes, one of the real powerful heroes in the game. Come on. Electro, we don't care about you. We don't care about you. Okay. Alright, so what do we got left? Simbites here. Alright, get some area effects down so they will just put them right on top of me, because these guys are just gonna jump over on top of me. Then we're gonna activate our other power, and then don't nuke them yet. Wait till there's a whole bunch of them. Come on, everybody, get out of the round. Here we go. Nuke me, right on top of me. Bam! There we go. All right, signature power. Bam! That is a lot of damage, by the way. Nuke's ready again. We've got to keep that nuke going because it's just, number one, it does a ton of damage, but number two, it procs all those other stats we looked at earlier. Come here, you. Come on, nuke him. Oh, teleported out there just in time.
Silence, minion.
Really? I'm going to have to fight all these guys myself. All right, where is Venom? We're going to go kill Venom for the bonus here. Hopefully, let's activate our ultimate power. Hopefully, it'll be ready again. Does not look. Oh, yes, it is. There it goes. I'm not 100% just overthrilled with this, although it does a ton of damage. It's just hard to control. Our Venom. Here we go. Bam! Oh, we didn't get a crit on it. I was hoping to go out with a big, fat, brutal strike rating and... Alright, so we just have a few heroes left in the game to go through here. We'll have all 53 of them upgraded, and let's see if we can nuke Karagi here. Come on, get him a good... 2 million, but not on Karagi. Bring on her physical power again. There's 1.7 million. Half a million. Plus he's standing in her aura. That can't be good for him.
Doom is forever unopposed.
One there. These guys will just literally just melt into a big, big bowl of nothingness. Oh, look, we completed our legendary quest. I wasn't even trying and we completed it. That's always a good thing. You know, half a million, to when we zap them with our 600,000, just our normal attack there, that's crazy good damage. Half a million again there, half a million again. Very good, very good. I enjoy Doom. He's very easy to play. He's got these really cool powers. He looks good. He sounds good. Everything about him is good. Every single thing about Doom is good. I cannot highly recommend him. He's probably one of the five most strongest heroes in the game, in my opinion. Because we talked about this many times throughout this review of heroes. But when you have many things going on, it's hard to focus on any one thing, and it weakens you overall. If you have one thing to focus on, and in our case, it's sorcery. You can see all of our points are in this category, sorcery. And, of course, we're getting our bonuses here, and a few bonuses here, and a few bonuses here. But we're focusing. And being able to focus on something gives us, you know, you could really fine-tune all your stats and everything. As far as our final stats, what did we end up with here? 45.6, still a little low. I'd like to get that critical hit rating up to 55.6. Even though we've got some really good items, it's a little low. And our brutal strike rating is 50.3. So, again, I'd like to get that up to about 55 on both of those categories. So just a few more points in each of those would be awesome. What I need to do is really look at his items to see if any of these items could be traded out for something better, because obviously we're not using any of the tech tree except for the one passive, and we're not using much of this tree. We are using, you know, some of it. We're not using any summon thing. So anything that gives us bonuses to summons, we don't need that because we're not going to be doing that. Looks pretty good so far. Yep, I definitely think he is a beast. Enjoying playing him. Thanks for watching. We will see you guys next time.